Jake's flea market today. Lots of stuff. Something tells me this isn't the prime time of year to come. Obviously, it's October. So, yeah. Let's see what we find today. Oh. Just stopped at this like outdoor antique mall market thing. So antique show. Okay, sure. Cool stuff. Bought something really neat, and I just see some candlesticks, and I'm sure he's gonna ask a lot of money for it. They got food. There's some wine back there. I'm gonna check out the antique mall real quick. Let's see what we find in there. Okay, so I have found my dream booth. Granted, I'm not sure if any of this is antique, but everything on it, or in it, is amazing. Oh my god, that's beautiful. Would I put that in my house? Probably not, but it's amazing. Oh my god, look at the Buddha eyes, cards, wood. Look at the table, Collins Hall table. And I am backing into something. What is this? I can't. Game board. It's a game board. Ivory Coast, Africa. Sup, everybody? What's this? Large sin used to cleanse self and surroundings of negative energy. $15. Okay. Oh, look at this bird. This beautiful carved bird wood. Amazing mid-century modern booth. Lots of light fixtures. Look at that one. Look at that. Just a stand. Let me back up a little bit. Look at the wall clock. Holy cannoli. How much do they want for that? 60. Rare vintage Pyrex. Yeah, you're right. I've never seen Pyrex that pattern before. But look. $300. That's amazingly good. Actually, I think that's a little over, but that's just me. And then, oh my god, look at this chip and dip bowl. 56. Okay. Ooh, I really like this. Can't see it. I'll back up a little bit. Look at that lamp with the curve. That's different. What else I got? It's a little wiener dog. Can't see him that well. It's like a planter? Maybe? Maybe it holds. I don't know. Dachshund. Men's dresser caddy. Huh. What are these? Okay. I'm not sure which is my favorite piece. probably this one. Holy cow, that's beautiful. We are on our way. There's a few booths around. Here's from a distance. Oh my god, look how retro those cups are. Those are awesome. Ooh! That clock. That clock is magic. Wow, 1964, 1965 World's, New York World's Fair glasses. This is a whole, that's a lamp, a table lamp. Well, that's different. There's a bunch of clock, another clock. There's another clock. This is unique. $135. Old school Tupperware. Ooh. Now you do not see that anymore. That is something different. This is a very nicely curated booth. How much are they asking for this ice bucket? 58? That's cute. That's really, really cute. And the monkeys. Oh, look at that ashtray. Look at that umbrella stand. It's dope. Oh my god. Look at that salt and pepper shaker. Oh my god. I don't know what this is. Let's see if I can read it. Vintage ceramic Asian boy bucket. How much is that? 24. That is really nice. I like that carafe is nice. Oh my god, everything in this booth is really nice. Here's another booth that feels like a mix of like farmhouse slash vintage slash stuff. These are adorable. The medical cabinet. Nice. I love this set though. You all know I love me that glassware. More glassware. Look at that lamp. Holy hell. The Tree of Life he's got. I believe this is called the Tree of Life. Something like that. Correct me if I'm wrong in the comments. Look at all these glasses. Oh my god, look at these. Those are pretty. Hey Kermit. Where's Kermit the Frog? Those are really nice. $14.50 for the set. That's not bad, actually. That is not bad at all. Look at these owls. Alright, let's see what's in here. Look at this mid-century China cabinet. What is happening? Oh my god, what the food? The container, canisters, excuse me. $48 for the set, that is not bad. That is not bad. Is it $48? Maybe. Look at the juice glass with the carafe. That's amazing. What? Hold on. What is this? Is this a Sputnik? I don't even know what that is. Oh, it's an ornament. Okay. This one? Oh my gosh. Like, this is perfect for that kitchen. That beautiful, I live by myself, nobody touch my crap kitchen. Look at the cat. Is that gravel art? It looks like gravel art, but it doesn't seem like gravel. I forget what those things are called that you sew on. I don't know. I just have to show this. This is adorable.
Hello, and welcome to the haul portion of today's video. As you can see, I went to a few I went to Jake's Flea Market in Pennsylvania. And it's October, so it was a little chilly that day. As you can see, there's a bit of overcast and not a lot of vendors, but still a good amount. And I found two things. But before I went to Jake's, I hit my local thrift store and I found this guy. He was not broken when I bought him. She's like, "Do you want a bag?" I'm like, "No, I don't need a bag." As I'm walking out, I'm looking at something, forgot he was in my hand, and he just flew. I'll post a before picture. So yeah, I picked up the pieces that fell off of him, but I mean, obviously I can't resell it. So yeah. Anyways, a lot of the items that you're going to see here tonight or today in this video, I'm going to post on my Poshmark and Mercari accounts for you guys to purchase. And let's keep going. All right, so I went to Jake's. I think I ended up finding two shirts. Yes, and here they are. Here is one super awesome vintage shirt. Bike Week Daytona Beach, front and back. I haven't looked up the comps on this, but something tells me this is pretty valuable. I don't know why. I think of and other YouTubers on here. I want to say Paul Cantu probably, you know, has featured shirts similar to this or has mentioned something like that. And then the second shirt is very Halloween inspired. I just had to get her. I mean, look at this. It's spooky as hell. And it's a really thick shirt, so it's perfect for fall, you know. I think I'm gonna just dry clean this. I'm not sure if this is spray paint. But yes, each of those were $4. Of course I would buy that. Then I picked up a shelving unit for myself. I'll pop a picture on it here. It's bamboo. I'm in love with it. I got a great deal for it. It was worth the hour and a half trip to go get her, to go get it. And yeah, so yeah. So then on my way back home, I decided to hit a thrift store. I think it's the thrift store, the proceeds go to animals in need or sheltered animals. Is it cats? I think it's more cats. Anyways, and as I was walking around, I found two VCR tapes still in plastic, 50 cents each. As mentioned in previous videos, I just buy as many of these brand new as I can, and then I'll lot them up and sell them. Then I found this. I wish this were my size. I'm not quite sure if it's vintage or not. Here's the tag. It was $4.99. I don't have my glasses. Yeah, there's no year. And, like, I don't know if you could tell, but, like, the design on it, it's pretty gnarly. Pretty, pretty gnarly. So, yeah, I said yes to this as well. And then that was it for Saturday. And then I was so sad that, oh, and then, oh, my bad, I forgot to show you what else I found at that outdoor antique little market that I stopped on my way to go pick up the shelving unit. I'll be right back. Are you ready? Somehow I have developed a collection of vintage planters. This guy cost me, that's a paperclip. $10. There's no markings on the bottom. He's in great condition. Like, I don't even want to wash it. I think it's just perfect. I might take a little mild soap to it just to get some dust off of it. But, oh my God, I'm in love. And I'm not gonna sell it. I'm sorry, guys. Not gonna sell this one. So yeah, that was it for Saturday. So then Sunday, I didn't film because it was just a quick multi-family yard sale near where I live. I really wasn't expecting a lot. And lo and behold, I did end up finding two things. This is a vintage cigarette holder. I believe she said her mom. Hold on, I gotta open this. Her mom went to Japan. Someone in her family definitely got this in a different, in Japan, or I wanna say China. I'm not sure. But yeah. So it holds your cigarette, right? And then you just close it up and it goes like that. And that's it. And I don't believe there's any markings on the bottom. Again, I don't have my glasses. But there's a nice little design of a crane on the bottom. So it's like an ashtray / cigarette holder type thing. And it just shut like that. Maybe you could put it in your purse. Because when I was in China, people would smoke and eat at the same time. Put it down at the edge of the table. Take a few bites. But anyway, so... And then I saw this, and I was like, so I am doing a gallery wall, like ocean themed, so it's like the sea, the ocean, dolphins, whales. I'll post a picture of it on here. I mean, it's not complete yet, but it's getting there. So I bought this bowl, and it looked like it was older, but it's not. She says it's Lennox. And it has little dolphins in it. It's very pretty, you know. So for $3, why not? And then, yeah, that's it. That's it. So, I mean, we're well into October. Yard sales aren't as popular as they usually are during spring and summer. But you still hit a few estate sales. I did hit an estate sale, actually. Did I? No, sorry. I didn't. I'm old. But yeah. So don't forget to like this video and hit the subscribe button. I post a video about once a week, I want to say. And that's it. Thank you for watching. Have a great day. Bye.